Hey y'all, welcome to the channel. This is my first video for this unnamed channel that I have. Haven't come up with a clever name yet, but I'm sure we will by the time that we get uploaded. Last night, me and my buddy Gulick, shout out to Gulick, thanks for going with me, dude. We went up to a exotic sale to try and find some bighorn sheep. I was looking for some mouflon, but of course we couldn't find any. Uh-oh, they see me. But we got some blackbellies instead. I'm happy with them. I mean, I didn't have to have the mouflon. I just preferred them. We got about 16 of these bad boys. And, well, we're about to welcome them to the farm. They're a little flighty, but I think they'll get used to me. Pretty cool guy. All right, so you can see I have a few Katahdin ewes over here and a Dorper ram back there in the back. I've had these guys for a couple years now, so learned a lot about sheep in the process of raising these guys over here. So I decided with my small acreage here, you can see I got about 3 acres fenced in. We were gonna get some horn sheep, bighorn sheep, and see if we can maybe generate some revenue instead of just having them as a hobby. That's my puppy, Anatolian Pyrenees mix in there. He's about 6 weeks old. 6 weeks old. He's not a big fan of being chained up, but he won't stay away from the house, so you gotta do what you gotta do. That's my last dog guardian dog. Meet Wolf. He's a bit of a whiner right now, but he's gonna be a good one. So he does with our new sheepers here. Oh, they're actually not as aggressive as my sheep that I've had. It's kind of surprising. These are a wild bunch. Well, he might take to these guys pretty well then. You can see when we brought them in last night, it was about 9:30. That's why I didn't mess with any of this then. We just quarantined them, which is important. Don't want to spread diseases and stuff from the barn, the sale barn. So we locked them up in here in this little pen. Actually had a few of the lambs get out, so hope nothing goes south with that. But I have this little chute here, and it's actually built for cattle. That's why it's so big. But now we have sheep. And down here at the bottom, I've got some cement mixing tubs. I got them at Lowe's. I think I paid about $40 for the 6 of them. They happen to fit pretty nicely in here, sideways. And what we're going to do is give these sheep a foot bath. We've got gravel down in the bottom of them. It's just rainwater. And I threw some debris, some leaves and twigs and stuff on top to attempt to keep them from drinking it. But I think they'll be all right either way. And what we put in there is this Premier Foot Care concentrate. I had a problem earlier this year with these guys getting foot rot, and I tried to do one at a time, quarantine one sheep or the other, and like I said, I learned a lot. That just doesn't happen. So I ended up getting this Premier Foot Care, and we run them through here, took care of the problem first time. So we're definitely going to use that with these blackbellies that I got. And we'll let them stay in here for, I don't know, maybe half an hour, something like that. I'm just going to run them in here and barricade this backside somehow to get them to stand in the solution that I mixed in the water there. And We'll see how it goes. All right, so it should be pretty easy. They're really floddy, so I'm sure they'll come right in. Gotta make sure that they're all standing in the cement tubs. So it just happens that these are a perfect width for this chute, so that as long as they're past this one in the back, they're definitely standing in it. Well, maybe they climb up on the head chute up there. But you gotta make sure there's no gaps or anywhere on the side that they can get their feet. Make sure you get them good. You mess up doing this and they bring something to the rest of your sheep, you're gonna have a bad year. Or, well, in my case, it's about a bad 6 months. All right, so as you can see, right here, you got a foot that's sticking out. Oh, there's another one. And they're good at it too. Touch them a little bit. Well, they usually stick it back in because they don't want to be touched. They don't like you. Ooh, I got dirty. Look at him. Man, they don't look happy. Y'all be all right. I'll take care of you. Okay, so the sheep have been in their foot bath for about an hour. I actually had to run and get some of the CDT vax from the feed store. But what we're gonna do to make things a little easier, I'm just gonna pull them out one at a time through the chute from the way they came in, vax them as they come back into this pen that they were in. Not the greatest of ideas to put them back where they're at, but kind of all I got to work with right now, so that's what we're gonna do. I think they'll be all right though, considering they soaked their feet for you know, a good hour in here. Well, I got 16 of them. Let's get to it. So this is what we're gonna be using to vax these guys. And it's always good practice to switch out your needles in between sheep. So just a good clean practice. That one got away from me. Whew. got him. So I vaxxed him, gave him a good long, hour and a half, however long it was, a foot bath. They should be good. That should take care of them.
Especially coming out of the cell barn.
I'm going to wait until a later date to worm them. For some reason, it seems like a lot of people like to give a little more than the recommended dosage on worming. So if these guys have been wormed, then I'll kind of give them a little break. Probably get them in about a month or something. And if they haven't been wormed, then when I get them in a month, they'll still be perfectly fine. No big deal. Otherwise, I would have wormed them today.
Should take care of them.
Just to make sure, like I said, personal experience, you don't want anything to transfer over and then you're fighting, you know, 30, 40 sheep with some craziness. So we'll keep these guys separated. It didn't rain the past, 2 days? So the ground's pretty dry. And that foot bath, like I said, it should get them pretty good. So I don't think that they'll keep anything in here. But if they do, I want to make sure that it just stays in here and doesn't spread around. Because you need to let your ground dry out. But the parasites die after 2 weeks or a month, depending on if you're going off recommended time or science. But that's pretty much it. Got them cleaned up. We should have taken care of any issues, diseases, parasites, or whatever they brought along with them. So now we're just gonna feed them. And feed them some more, and then I'll probably feed them some more after that. And that's how we welcome sheep to the farm here. Look at these guys down here grubbing for some hay. Like, I didn't just feed them today. Then I have a protein tub. I didn't give them some sweet feeding corn. Acting like they're dying over here. The grass is always greener on the other side, I guess.
But they sure do like wolf hair.
Alrighty. Well, that's it. I'm going to go help my buddy, Gulick, the one who went with me to the sale. Going to go out to his place. Help him do a few things and just kind of chill. I am soaking wet, pants all the way up to the thighs. It was a good time though. I mean, I enjoyed it, kind of. All right, Wolf, tell him bye or bite him. All right, cool, whatever. All right, y'all, thanks for watching. Expect more sheep vids to come. I kind of enjoyed it. It's a little weird, but I kind of enjoyed it. See you guys next time.